segments in DNA are so good. Today, I'm going to give you two for just watching one video. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Fam History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on that bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes. DNA segments can be really useful in genealogy because they help to identify whether or not you might have a common ancestor with someone else. Now, GEDmatch has a couple of different tools that I'm going to show you today how you can use these segments to find other people that share those segments. Now, one of these tools is a tier one tool, and the other is a brand new free tool that you can use today. So over on GEDmatch, we're gonna go look at the tier one tool first. Now, this is part of the paid subscription, and this is called Segment Search. Now, this is gonna allow us to search for particular segments that we may share in common with other people. So when we're on the segment search screen, what we need to do is we need to enter a kit number. And this is going to be the kit that it's finding all the matches for those segments of that kit. Now in this case, I'm going to use just one of my kits. Next, it's going to ask us what's the maximum number of matches we want to look at. It defaults to just your 1,000 closest matches, but you can go up to 10,000 matches if you want to. I'm just going to leave it at 1,000. You have the build to display, and this defaults at B37. If you want to show B36 or B38, you can do that. And then we have, just like with most matching, if you want to change the thresholds, the minimum number of SNPs or the minimum segment size to be able to look at, then you can do that. I usually just leave this at the defaults. The next part is what chromosomes we want to scan. Now we can scan all of them by default, or we can scan a particular chromosome. Today I'm going to show you just one chromosome. I'm going to do chromosome number one because it's the longest chromosome. And I'll come back to these other two here in a moment. But then we want to submit, and this is going to take us to the match screen. So once we get to the match screen, it's going to take about, 10, 20, maybe 30 seconds to gather all the data, and then you'll be seeing this. Now, right at the beginning here, it's going to give you a little warning that it didn't have any matches closer than 2100 centimorgans. So this would be siblings and parents. It would also be some of your half siblings, some of your aunts and uncles, some of your grandparents, if you shared a lot of DNA with them. And it does this just to conserve resources because that's going to increase the total number of matches that there are. But even if you don't have those people included, you're still going to get a lot of great data from this information. Now, as we go down, we can look and see that we have the kit number. We have what chromosome it is. And in this case, I just looked at chromosome one. We have the start and the end position. We have how much centimorgans we share, how many SNPs, then we have their contact information. And then there's a little graphic over here that shows us roughly where on that chromosome it fits. Now, as part of this graphic, we can see that there's different colors. This is to get different matches together in the same general area. So for instance, when we're looking at these red ones right here, if we come over to the start position, we see that hey, all those red ones start roughly in the same spot between 750,000 and 800,000. And then it switches over to orange, which jumps up to 4 million. So there's a definite gap in between there. And then we see that at yellow right here, oh, they're starting at around 137 or 13 million is where those are. Now that isn't going to mean that everything is all close together. So for instance, the yellow starts at 13 million, but it goes all the way down to 30 million in this case. This is helpful in that by color coding these, we can get a rough idea of where some groups may be. So for instance, if I'm looking at a group, I can see that, hey, all these reds, they all share almost the same starting point, and some of them share the same ending point. We see this 121, 121, 121, 121, But if I actually look down, I can see that, hey, there's a couple of these 40s that also share that 121. So there's a good chance that this whole group might have some different groups of triangulation within it, just because there's so much commonality between those segments that's shared. And so this should be a big clue to help you know what we want to do next. Now, what do you want to do next? Well, there's two options really here. First off is we can download this. You click on this and you're going to get this information now into a CSV file, which you can put in a spreadsheet. And depending on how you organize your matches, that may be something that's really useful to you. The other way is through the multiple kit analysis. Now, since this is a tier one tool, we can use the multiple kit analysis. And to do that, all we need to do is check certain boxes. So in this case, hey, you know what? I'm going to check these boxes right here. And I'm going to not just check the red ones, I'm going to check these orange ones too, since I saw some commonality as far as where they were ending. And then I can go and I can click on the multiple kit analysis and do some further work on that. Now the multiple kit analysis just takes me over to the GEDmatch visualization options, and then I have a lot of other tools that I can use to analyze all of those kits. So now that gives us our big segment list. But what if we want to narrow it down to just something really specific? That's where a couple of these other options come in. Now, I said before that we want to just look on chromosome 1, but let's say that I've already identified a triangulation group on chromosome 1, and it is between 65 million and 120 million. What I can do is I can look for the matches that just overlap that segment. Now, in this case, since I'm just looking at this one segment, I might want to increase the overall matches. So I'm going to go from that 1,000 to 10,000. So it's going to look at my 10,000 closest matches to see who matches in this chromosome 1, 65 million to 120 million. So now what it's done is it's gone through and it's analyzed just for the segments that overlap with the 65 million to 120 million. Now, it can overlap at any amount, as we'll see in this match list. So for instance, so here we see a couple of matches that they just overlap a little bit right here in the 65 to 68 million. Now they go down to 62 million, but the overlap is really just a really tiny part of that. Whereas others, like these first two right here, they overlap between 20, 30 million and 120 million. So they actually cover a very large range of that, from 65 million to 120 million. And really, it's anywhere within that. If there is any part of a matching segment that falls within that 65 to 120 million range, then it's going to show up on here. So you can see that this list is a much shorter list, but I have the same functionality that I can download that as a CSV file, or if I want to do the multi-kit analysis, then I can check some of those and go to the multi-kit analysis to analyze them in some different ways. So that is the first tool, the Tier 1 Segment Search. It allows you to see which segments you match with your matches rather than just seeing that you match somebody. And that can help you to group together which matches you want to look at as a group, as opposed to just looking at an entire match list. Now, if you don't have Tier 1, there's a way that you can do something similar, but also a little bit more focused. This is a new feature that showed up just in the last couple of weeks, and it is called Ancestor Projects. It's right down there at the bottom. Now, this is going to be able to do something similar, but you have to be part of a project. So I'm going to go to the page and show you what it looks like, then also talk about what you need to do to get to be part of a project. So on the Ancestor Project, you'll see that a lot of the information you enter in is the same stuff that you enter in for the segment search. So the first thing, I'm going to enter in my GEDmatch kit number. And then if I want to change the segment threshold, I can change that. I can add in what chromosome I want to look at specifically. And just like with the segment search, I can add in a lower and an upper limit as far as a position on that chromosome. I can sort it in different ways, and then I'm going to go and get my list. Now, this is the list of this project. Now, so what it is doing is it's doing a subset of all of my matches. It's only doing those that are part of this project. And so you have to have joined projects to be able to get this. And I'll explain those projects in just a minute of why they can be so valuable. So in this case, in this project, there's only three people that match me. And I can see from the chromosome and the start and the end location, they all match me on different chromosomes in different locations. But if I wanted to do the select, I can select on the boxes and then go to the multiple kit analysis and look at those kits in some other different ways. Now, in this case, there was 29 kits in this project. So this isn't comparing to a whole lot of kits. Depending on how big the project is, will depend on whether or not you can get any information out of this. So let's go back and let's take a look at the projects. Now, if you've done some work with family tree DNA, you know that family tree DNA has their projects that you can join, which allows other people to see specific parts about your DNA. And usually those projects are centered around a surname or a location or a family or something like that. In this case, it's the same way. You can set up a project really based on just about anything. And it's going to give you a list of the available projects right now. And again, this is really new, just within the last couple of weeks in August of 2019. So if you're looking at this video, you know, a year or 2 years from now, there might be lots more projects to join. But there'll be the name of the project, there'll be a description, and then there'll be an email contact or some other way of contacting the administrator of that project. So you can go through and you can see some of the different things that people are looking at. And down here at the bottom, it gives you some information on if you want to set a project, what do you need? So if you want to set up a project, then what you need is you need at least 20 kits. And that can be your own family's kits, maybe that you manage. It can also be any of your matches, maybe that you've identified that you want them to all be part of the project. And what you're going to do is you're going to arrange those in a spreadsheet and send that information to GEDmatch. And then they will review over that, get that project set up, and identify, you know, who the project administrators are and have your project listed on here. And so then in the future, if you have other people that want to join that project, then they'll be able to join that project and be able to add their DNA to it. Now, the idea behind this is you want to have people in a project who have some common DNA. So you're sharing either some particular ancestor or maybe you're all from some particular part of the world. But anything that might have an idea of how you share DNA. And like I said, since this is a brand new feature, there's not that many projects right now, but I'm hoping that as time goes on, we're going to see a lot more projects that people may want to be able to be a part of. So that is two tools that you can use to search for segments on GEDmatch. Now, segment searching is really good because from that, you can go on to triangulation and seeing how you are related to certain common ancestors. And it really helps to organize your work in identifying the people that are likely related to the same common ancestors. So if you have any questions about segment search or about the ancestor projects, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it for you. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with all your friends.